plethora of beauty products out there, there are obviously going to be some hits and some misses. Today I have an empties video for you, so I want to share with you the products that I will be purchasing again and some that I will not be purchasing again. First up, I have the Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser. I've been using this cleanser for well over 2 decades. My dermatologist recommended it to me when I was going through a very bad phase with my skin, and I have not stopped using it since. It's just a beautiful cleanser that is very gentle on the skin, so it's great for sensitive skin. It can be used with or without water. It is great for the body as well. I use it to also take my makeup off, so I don't really have a makeup remover. I find this is great for removing makeup. It is very affordable. This 1 liter tub is about $25 and it will last about 4 months. So yes, I will be repurchasing, as I have done for about 25 years. This is the Neostrata Ultra Smoothing Lotion with an AHA 10. My dermatologist recommended that I use this in conjunction with the Cetaphil. So this not only acts as a moisturizer, but it enhances skin clarity and texture because of the AHA. It contains glycolic acid of 10%, so it actually exfoliates your skin chemically. It's also really good for hyperpigmentation, any dark spots, and is supposed to be used in conjunction with an SPF. So I also use this morning and night. This is a 200ml tube. I get it from Chemist Warehouse and it's around $45. It also lasts a very long time because you need a very small amount. So since I have also been using this for more than 2 decades, of course, I will be repurchasing this one. This is a hand wash by Nature. That's the actual brand, by Nature. It's made in New Zealand. It contains rosehip oil and argan oil. I'm absolutely loving rosehip oil at the moment. I have an oil for my face. I've recently bought a new body moisturizer containing rosehip oil. I just absolutely love the benefits. I love the way it leaves my skin so hydrated. And since I've been using the rosehip oil on my face, I've found that my T-zone is not as oily anymore, which is crazy. This is a beautiful hand wash. I absolutely love the way it smells. It smells so beautiful. I just cannot explain it. It is a 495ml bottle and costs recommended retail $13, but I paid $7 for it at TK Maxx. I'm definitely gonna go back and see if they have any more of this. I absolutely love it. It's just so hydrating and smells so amazing, and looks really pretty on the bathroom counter as well. This is a hairspray by Batiste. It is the Hold Me Hairspray 24 Hour Invisible Hold. I'm pretty sure this made it on one of my favorite videos months ago. I've really changed my mind about this product. I would not buy this again, and this is the reason why. The way I like to use hairspray is to spray it on my hands first, and then go into my hair and tame away the flyaways and, you know, go through any bits that I want, texture, or if I'm styling my hair in a slick back pony, I like to use my hands and just slick it all back. When I go to wash my hands, it leaves a very thick film on my hands and actually comes off in chunks when I wash my hands. I'm standing there washing my hands a couple of times to get all the film off, and because that's the way I use hairspray, I will not be repurchasing again. If you spray this directly onto your hair, then I'm sure you wouldn't have that problem, and I guess it's a good hairspray, but it is quite expensive. This was $16. It's a 300ml, very tall tin, so it doesn't fit on the top shelf of my cabinet in the bathroom. It's just not really worth it for me. There are so many more other hairsprays on the market that are less expensive and do a much better job. So although this is the brand Batiste and I love their dry shampoo, I do not love their hairspray. So no to this. Who doesn't use facial cleansing wipes? They are so good when you're on the go, when you're traveling, when you're too lazy to wash your makeup off. These are fantastic. I love the simple ones. I think these are the original ones. The reason why I love these ones so much, and I have tried many, is because my skin is really sensitive and these are so gentle on my skin. They don't irritate my skin at all. They don't burn my skin. They don't itch my eyes. They take off waterproof mascara. It's just amazing how good these are. You can get them in a 2-pack from Chemist Warehouse. I usually pay around $9 for the two pack. I will definitely be repurchasing these again. I love Palmer's body lotions. They just smell so beautiful. No matter which one you get, they have a shea butter, a cocoa formula, a coconut formula. They all smell incredible. They are very moisturizing, 24-hour moisture, and they're so cheap. A 250ml bottle, which will last you at least a couple of months, only cost $10. I use this as soon as I get out of the shower every single night. What can I tell you? This is an excellent product. It's so affordable, it's so moisturizing, and it smells like it should cost so much more than what it is. So I'm definitely gonna keep repurchasing these babies. I use a SPF every single day, whether or not I'm wearing makeup, and this is the one I love. It's the Aveeno Daily Moisturizer containing SPF 15. I have a Mediterranean background, so I have olive skin, and the SPF 15 is enough for my skin. So for those of you who need a higher factor SPF, this may not work for you, but for me, it is amazing. This little tube here is 75 mils. It cost $20 from Chemist Warehouse. It doesn't leave a white film on your face like some other moisturizers containing SPF. I feel like it's very hydrating and smoothing, so I feel very radiant when I have this on, and it looks great under makeup. It doesn't disturb my makeup at all. This is such a great product. If you've been on the hunt for a good moisturizer containing SPF, I highly recommend this one. Yes, I will definitely repurchase. What can be more attractive than beautiful white teeth? I think eyes are really important, but a beautiful smile and white teeth are probably second to me. And I try to never neglect my teeth, make regular dentist appointments. And as for my toothpaste, I brush morning and night. And this is what I use, the Colgate Optic White. If you use this consistently day and night, I guarantee you, your teeth will be whiter. It is just the best toothpaste I've ever tried. I will never stop using it. Depending on which size tube you get, they are approximately $10 to $12, but worth every cent. So good, this toothpaste, so good. The deodorant that I use and have been using for probably as long as my skincare is this Norske Forest Fresh deodorant. Do you remember that ad for this Norske deodorant? There was a woman, I think, bathing under a waterfall in a beautiful Scandinavian forest. Well, that is what this smells like. It is so fresh. It is not perfumey and strong. It's just a beautiful, clean, fresh, crisp, subtle fragrance that keeps you feeling fresh all day. I love this deodorant. It just never lets me down. I get it from Coles or Woolworths. It costs around $6 for this 150ml bottle. I also buy the smaller roll-on tube, which I take with me for traveling, and it's just what I use. So yes, 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 yes. This is the Echo Tools Beauty Sponge, and at first I liked this product. No, it is not as soft and bouncy as the Beauty Blender, and no wonder that Beauty Blender is $30, because there is no other beauty sponge like that one, in my opinion. But $30 is a little steep to spend on a beauty sponge, so we do look for cheaper alternatives to save a few dollars, and that's what I had in mind when I got this one. It doesn't really do the job. It's not as soft and bouncy as I mentioned, but after a few washes, it just cracked. If you can't thoroughly wash a beauty sponge with just soap or makeup remover, whatever it is you use, and water, and just squeezing it around to get all the makeup out, if it can't withstand that kind of pressure or vigorous washing, then really it's not worth your while. It's important to keep your beauty sponges clean so they don't breed bacteria and infect your skin. So no, I won't be repurchasing this one. It did cost about $16 if I remember correctly. Although it did the job, it wasn't as good as the Beauty Blender, no way, and obviously the quality is not there. When I'm not using my Maybelline Brow Drama and can be bothered to fill in my brows, I use the e.l.f. brow pencil. It's such a great brow pencil and is as cheap as chips. I think it's about $6 from Kmart. It has a fantastic spoolie on one end and the pencil on the other end is creamy, but not too creamy that it slides everywhere. The pigment is definitely there. It doesn't make your eyebrows look too blocky. You can really work natural strokes with it. It's just a very affordable but excellent brow pencil in my opinion. So yes, I will definitely repurchase again. I have one already in my makeup collection. This is a duo product by e.l.f. I believe one side is for the eyebrows and one side is for the eyelashes. I did not like this product. I found the clear mascara to be very just useless. It didn't do anything for my eyelashes. The eyebrow section to just groom them in place, I felt it came out very gray and just didn't really hold them in place, and I would not recommend this product. I did want a product for my eyebrows that was completely natural with no pigment, and that's why I went for this one, but this does not work at all for me. I do love the e.l.f. wax pencil though. I love it. It keeps them in place, and that's one I will keep repurchasing, but this one, no. So that is it for all my products. I can go and throw all those out in the recycle bin. Once again, they accumulate so quickly. I hope you got a kick out of seeing what products I love and what products I don't. Thank you so much for watching this video, and until next time, take care.